Okay, let's do some math for fun and to have a look inside. Here we have 16, which is the same as 4 squared, and then minus x squared. Likewise, this is 3 squared minus x squared. When we have a difference of 2 squares instead of a square root, we can actually construct a right triangle. Let me show you how. First, if we have a right triangle right here, let's call this A, B, and C. By the Pythagorean theorem, we know that A squared plus B squared equals C squared. But I don't want to look at the sum of two squares. I want to see a difference of two squares. So let me minus the B squared on both sides, so we get A squared equals C squared minus B squared, and then take the positive square root. So we can see that this A has the form like that. Similarly, we can do the same thing right here. But let's focus on this right here first. 16, as I said earlier, is 4 squared. This right here corresponds to the C, the hypotenuse. So I'll draw a triangle for you guys right here. This right here will be 4. Minus x squared, which corresponds to this side right here. So that will be down here like this. Still x. And then for the A, well, because we have a right triangle, we know we can just open the square root. Hypotenuse squared, which is 16, and then minus this side squared, which is x squared. So a right triangle from that part. So if you have done some calculus with like trig substitution, you'll be like, oh yeah, yeah, like that, right? Now, for the second part, we can also do the same thing. This is the same as 3 squared, but don't draw another triangle on the side somewhere. Because this right here has also minus x squared. Let's put it together. The 3 is the hypotenuse, but let's go like this. So let's go like this. That's 3. 3 squared, hypotenuse. Minus x squared, so it's x right here. And then finish our right triangle here. This is also a right angle. This side is precisely square root of the hypotenuse for the blue triangle, which is 3 squared right here, and then minus that side squared, which we have the x squared, which is that. And you can see that on the bottom, we have this first term plus the second term. It must be equal to 5. Ooh, look at this. Look at this. The numbers are so nice, because if you look at the big triangle, you can see we have a 3, 4, 5 triangle. And by the inverse or the reverse version of the Pythagorean theorem, when the three sides fit into a Pythagorean theorem, then that must be a right triangle. So in fact, this angle must be 90 degrees. I know. If this right here was equal to 6, then this wouldn't work out nicely. Yeah, but it does. So now, let's see, what geometry can we do? Well, you can take this for the base, and take that for the height, and compute the area. But also, you can take this for the base, and take that for the height, and compute the area. And the area has to be equal. So, if you look at the area, well, we have 1/2. Take this for the base and that for the height first. So we have 5 times x. And then that must be equal to 1/2 times this for the base and that for the height. So 3 times 4. Ah, just like this. Look at that. Cancel out the 1/2 on both sides. We're looking at 5x equals 12. And then divide the 5 on both sides. X is equal to 12 over 5. Not yet though, technically, because we use geometry to solve this algebra equation. For geometry, the x has to be positive, but we are trying to answer this original question, and of course, positive x and negative x will both satisfy this equation. So the answer for this equation, x is equal to plus or minus 12 over 5. Yeah, that's it. And of course, I will say the geometry way is more beautiful, but here's the deal. Sometimes when you are doing a geometry equation, maybe you end up with an algebra equation that you have to solve. And the truth is, sometimes when you are trying to solve an algebra equation, maybe geometry can help. And this is what I like about math. And I know you guys are watching my videos because you guys love math as well, and some of you guys would even like to learn more math. And if so, I would like to tell you guys about our sponsor for today, Brilliant.work. Brilliant has been a long-time sponsor for this channel, and I really believe in what they have to offer. They have over thousands of lessons in algebra, geometry, calculus, and a lot more. All of their courses are interactive with beautiful animations to help you visualize, and short quizzes to test your understanding. You can check out their math contest courses, which they cover typical topics such as polynomial equations and various geometry facts, but all in a deeper level. I started to like math when I was in high school, and I really wish that I could have Brilliant back then. But now you have the chance to get started with Brilliant for 30 days free. And if you use the link in the description, brilliant.org/blackpenrepen, you can get 20% discount. I want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video, and I also want to thank you guys for checking them out.